Let's get started. I want you to come to attention and I want you to bow. Yeah, this class is recorded, but it's the same as any one of our classes that we would do on Zoom live. So it might be a little grainy and everything, but that's just how it's done. I've got the karate belt here of mine. I'd like you to take your belt off if you'd like, if you have your belt. If you want, turn the tape on. I almost said tape. This isn't a tape. Turn the recording off and go grab your belt. You got plenty of time. What I'm going to work on today is just a couple of things, but I thought I'd be remiss if I didn't see if you could or challenge you to tie your own karate belt. All right. Now there's two ways. Let's say you want to show somebody how to do this. That's kind of what my reason for doing it this way. There's two ways. One is I grab it in the middle and hold it like this. This is the easy way. And I put that middle on my belly button and I switch around behind my back. Okay. And this is the first way that I ever learned how to tie a belt. And you take it from here and then you just, all you do, I got black uniform, black belt, and it's kind of sunny outside. So it's a lot of contrast. I put one hand down, one hand over, and then I take it through both loops. So it's contained, it's not loose. Now, if you do it through one loop, if I just tie these two together out here, I wind up with separation between the two layers. And that just doesn't cut it. You wanna have your belt be one solid line. So as we come across, go underneath both the initial loop and then the second one too. So you have something like this. See, you get a top, and then the bottom. What do we call these, like little tails or something like that? And then we'll go in, take the top one over the bottom, and you tie it. And voila, as the French say, you've got yourself a belt knot. Now you want to be able to pull that snug and everything. There's that way, and mine's kind of messed up here because I'm not even looking at it, but there's that way. Again, that was the way where you cut it in half, and you just go, I just need to get out there. This is what happens when you're like running late, you just go in, you put the top one over the bottom, pull it through, you get it out there, you bow in, and you're ready to go to class, right? That's kind of how things work. Now, we want to look a little snazzier, I guess, if you can do that with a karate belt, is that I'm going to take my belt and wrap it around like I'm coiling it around myself. Now, I have my name on it. And I usually take the one with my name on it, and I turn it upside down. Or inside out. If you don't have any writing on your belt, it doesn't matter. You can use tape on your belt. You can say the colored tape or the black tape and figure it out that way. Whatever way, just try to be consistent. Now I'm gonna create a little bit of a tail here. I'm gonna put that on my navel or belly button. I'm gonna reach around my hack and try to get it so I can hold it here. I switch hands, I wrap it over once. And then I run it right around the line again. So then I have a clean line all the way around. So the belt looks like it's one continuous loop around my body. Yep. I can walk the fashion catwalk here if you'd like. I don't think that's me though. Pull it snug. Inhale. Okay. Make sure they're the same length. Otherwise, it makes you look like you don't know what you're doing. And then you at least have your belt looking good. You may not know what you're doing, but at least your belt will look good, okay? So now when I get done with this, hopefully I'm somewhere near the same length. I think I got it. And so when I do that, I can tie my belt relatively quickly, just wrapping it around in a coil. I'm left-handed. Now, when we look at this on camera, or you're looking at this on your computer screen, this is on your right side. So this actually is the way that I would do it if I were you, if you're right-handed. If you're left-handed, you know, you're going to have, well, invert the tape or whatever. But if you're left-handed, just try it doing it that way as well. And we'll see me afterward. But I mean, this is one way that I like to teach people how to tie their own karate belt. Okay? All right. So let's come to attention and bow here. Now, this class is with people with a little bit of experience up to a fair amount of experience, or intermediate levels. So let's get started with 20 jumping jacks. Ready and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, put your feet apart. That's good. And I'm going to go through these quickly. And so we can get right to it. You can stretch out on your own if you like. You can pause this recording and then go back to it. But we're going to go, we like to go wide apart first, don't we? We like to go toes or fingers to the ground. Then we're going to go to the side. Doesn't matter which. Now the other. And now back. We come back up. Toes, fingers down to the ground. Ooh, a little tight. There we go. Now you remember now, if you can't quite touch your toes, just grow your fingernails real long and then it makes it a lot easier. All right. Now we sit on the ground and do wide apart and butterflies and everything like that, but let's just go from here. Okay? Now what I'd like to have you do is first things is let's get ourselves set in our defensive stance. We start at attention, we bow. We step back and say, Aya. Now my hands do a little bit of a crisscross here as I come back to this position. All right, so I'm gonna have my left hand in front, my right hand behind me. And so what I'm gonna have here is kind of a loose fist. So I'm gonna be in this position here, and let's just take ourselves through a series of techniques, okay? So we're just gonna kind of go in like so. I'm gonna take my front hand, and I'm just gonna reach out and come back. And we'll call this a jab. So jab, ready? We'll do five of them. One, two, three, four, five. Now there's a lot of things we can do with a jab. Now let's try doing it this way, where we move toward me, toward the camera, toward the computer. We go, we're gonna step in with our front foot, pow, and jab out here like so. Now let's, this is all designed today on small space, not the big karate room space, just a little bit of space. So let's just take a little bit of a step and come right back to where we started from. Ready and jab. Good. Ready? Jab. Good. Jab. And jab. Good. Switch your feet. All right. So we're going to front jab. We're going to pop out here. Stationary. Ready? One, two, three, four, five. Moving in. Ready? Jab in. Come back. Ready? One, two, three, four, five. Good. Switch it. Now take your jab and do your punch. All right. So front hand, jab, cross punch with the back hand. And do five of them. Ready? Go. That'd be one. Ready? And two. Good. Three. Four. And five. Good. Ready to switch it. Right hand, left hand. Ready, set, and go. Ready? One. Two. Three, four, and five. Good, 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 good. Now, turn this way, and let's go through our kicks. Start with our front kick. Front kick, come back down again. Good, all right. You know, I really don't care which leg you use, however you stand. I'm standing here like so, and I'm turning so that what would be on your left side, this is my right hand, all right, and my front leg is going to be doing the kicking. Now, I'm not stepping here. It's going to be here, lean back and flick. Just like I have a little bit of mud on my shoe, I'm going to get it off before I go back in the house again, all right? We've had a lot of rain lately, haven't we? So we go here like so. I've got my hands up and loose. Everything is loose. We're just practicing our technique. Snapping it up. Let's do five of them. My knee's going to come up to my belt. One. Two. Three. Four and five. Switch it. Let's go on this side. Ready? And snap it out. Ready? And one, two, three, four, and five. All right. So now we're going to go in here like this, facing each other. I'm going to go, you know, I'm thinking, let's put a left leg in front. We're gonna do two front kicks. We're gonna go right into it. I'm gonna go front kick one, front kick two, and then I'm gonna punch. All right? So just like so. I'm moving in and skipping back. Got my starting point right here. One, two, punch it out. Come on back. Ready? And go. Punch it out. Come on back. Set. pop. Okay, one more time. That's good. All right, great. Now we're going to change the kick a little bit. Instead of doing a front kick, we are going to do a round kick. Now, a round kick is kind of like a front kick, except we turn and come across this way. It's a kick with a lot of variation to it. It's an awesome kick. So I'm going to be here. I'm going to take my toes up. I'm sorry, I said that wrong. I'm going to get on my toes, kind of bouncing this way. I'm going to turn a little bit to the side. This gives me my chance, my hip to come up sideways like this. Point my knee at you or the camera, and then just flick my foot out toward the camera. Boom, done, easy peasy. There we go, ready, go. Set it up, boom, just like so. Now you've done this before. But I'm starting out easy, and I'm gonna do it the other side. Just gonna review, I got my toes pointed at you, I point my toes to the side, I get my hands up, I'm gonna pick my knee up, flick my foot out. Boom, I gotta point my knee right at the camera, right at the computer, tablet, phone, whatever. We're gonna point our television, point it right at you. Here we go, up with a knee and snap it out. Yep, just keep going, yep. Up, up, yep. Couple more, and one more. So we'll go like this. That was easy, I think it was easy. Gonna take it like so. Same combination. I'm gonna go with a front kick. Okay? Let me see if I can do it this way. What if I did it this way? I'm gonna do it two ways, I think. Maybe I'm overthinking this, but I'm gonna kick and bring it foot my foot back. Okay? So I go one, two. Now as I do that, I turn sideways. Maybe? So I go up and turn. Now from here, I just snap my round kick. Now, we go in like so. So let's do a set, let's say of just five, that way. So we go one, here, kick, throw the right hand. All right, so now how do my feet go? And I'm thinking this is probably one way of doing it. If you find it confusing, bear with me. I'm gonna change it in just a minute. So I'm gonna go here like so. My knee's gonna come up and flick, got it. I'm gonna bring it back behind me, then around. So we're gonna go one, two, three. One, two, three. Ready to go. One, two, and three. Last one. Boom. Now, same thing. Nothing changes. Now I'm going that direction. Right toward the mirrors. You can see it better from this side, probably. Anyway. Just like so. Now that could easily be a side kick too. All right, we're just trying to make it a round kick too. Here, hit, here, like so. Right, hit, here, like so. Oh yeah, let's get that punch in there too. Let's do it a few more. Height doesn't matter, get it at least as high as your belt. If you can kick to your head, good, good, great. Let's just go here. Pop, pop, boom. One more, uno más. Ready and go. Boom. Again, short space. If we got some room, we can do it this way. I kick, I put my foot in front. Now I've got to spin my whole body around and kick here and punch. It's not that big a deal, but it does take a little bit of practice to go from here to pivot this foot, punch it, to pivot this front foot so you can get it going. Otherwise, you wind up going kick and doing a round kick like that. And that's what I'm trying to avoid in today's class. Okay, so either way, second way is how we normally do it, frankly. Front kick, land in front, turn, round kick. And I'm just putting that extra step in there just to highlight the need to turn our body. Otherwise, it's one, two, and three. Okay? Having done all that, let's do it on the other side. All right? So we're gonna go left leg up, and then back to the mat. Turn our body as we get back here. Turn it, snap our kick out. Okay, left leg up, and snap, just like that. Up, and snap. Up, snap, and then just like so. Ready and go. Boom, just like so. Ready, kick. Boom, good. Ready, go. Yeah, again. Oh, I forgot to tell you, you can get fancy at this point. If you got the balance, throw a couple extra kicks, okay? I'm just gonna stay with the tried and true one kick each. Let's go to the side now. So you can see here, I'm gonna be, where's my footwork? This is better. I'm gonna go here, back, snap it, and fire that punch. Ready, and go. Boom, like so. Ready, go. Nice and fluid, nice and relaxed. Boom, there you go. So as we do that combination, front kick and then the round kick, two vital kicks for our training. All right, so let's move up and let's practice one more combination today, the side kick and the turn side kick, and put those together. Now to make that work, let's get ready, knees bent, hands up, and do a series of 10, five with each leg, alternating backward. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and now here. Let me face this way. As I go to kick, I don't want to bring my knee forward. No, I don't want my leg to go in two different directions. All I do is pick my heel up here and shoot it back. That's important. Both of these kicks have to come straight from that position, that chambered position. Chamber and a fire, chamber and a fire, all right? Now, let's not worry about where our shoulders are at this time or our posture or anything like that. Work on balance. Work on being on one foot. Work on being able to switch from side to side. So I go one side and the other, okay? Just like so, all right? So let's do a few facing sideways. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven, eight, nine, and 10. Now if I lose my balance, get your balance back and keep on going, all right? Don't worry about it. Two kinds of people in karate, right? Those that will fall and those that have fallen. When we stand on one leg, that's where things get rough, amongst other places. All right, so here we go. So those kicks like that allow us, doing those back kicks, get our hips in line for our balance, for our combination of side kick, turn side kick. Now, the front leg side kick, I am turned all the way to the side. I'm just gonna do these low, all right? Boom, down here, I'm gonna turn around. Boom, down here, like so. Now, if I'm fancy, let's say, if you're here, if you practice these more than just a few, you can do it on the other side now. Now, this would be your right leg. Boom, here to the side. I turn around, boom, here to the side. It's just that that's what we're doing. I'm going from here, turning my back, and turning here. The hard part is taking your eyes off what you're doing. You gotta turn and reacquire the target with your vision. So when we do this, get your eyes around first and then kick, because developing that balance and the ability to move and stand tall without, and go from focus on the target, breaking focus, and then getting it back right away, that's the key. All right, everything else will fall into place. And if you find yourself losing your balance a lot, slow down. Slow down more. Slow down as much as you can until you get it right. And you're gonna find out a couple things that'll happen. And let's do it a few times and then I'll talk us through it at the end. We're gonna do it five times each way. So I'm gonna side kick, turn, and my feet, oh, I forgot to mention this. My feet are apart, right? So when I turn, one leg is back, and one leg is forward. Now I just from here then, I just kick with that back leg. All right, and then I can bring my body around. And that is the building blocks of turning and side kick. We're really not doing a big spin. All we are is turning from here to there and then kicking back behind us. Big deal, all right? It's not that big a deal. So let's get to it. I'm going slow, old and gray. Okay. Ready, set. One, turn, look, kick. Thumbs up. Coming on back. Ready? Okay. So I'm going to turn a little bit. My foot up. Bump. Eyes around. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Pow. Right down the pipe. Okay. Just like so. Now from here, there's two ways. Again, some people will go, they'll kick and they'll put their foot back down here like so. That's a shortcut, but it throws your balance off. Complete the movement by going all the way around. Like what I mean by it is like this. Get your kick out. Get your second kick out. Put it on the ground and keep looking. All right, get yourself reacquired here. We're set. We're gonna kick. We're gonna turn. And then we're gonna kick again. Now hitting the pad, all right, covers a lot of mistakes because we can hit the pad any number of ways. But having to do this with no target or no contact, where we have to control our weight the whole way, that takes a lot more skill. So if you're doing this all the way, I think you're learning a great lesson here. All right, so here we go. Hands up. We'll do one more time on this side. Side kick here, turn, side kick there. All right, facing that way. Right leg first. Kick, turn, look, see it, kick. Yeah, come on back. Ready, set, and kick, turn, kick. Yeah. Now I'm kind of cheating a little bit on this one. I'm doing this one here. I'm kicking here, and then when I bring my foot back, it's not pointing at the mirrors anymore. I'm kicking and I'm bringing my foot back here. So all I gotta really do now is kick, and boom, I'm already where I need to be. Boom, right there. All right, and that's exactly how we want that to go. A few more times now. Side kick, turn, side kick, and let's put a punch at the end of it just to make this side a little more complex. One, two, three, okay, here we go. Ready, and one, two, and three. Great, ready, and one, two, and three, just like so. I'm going slow, I want you to go slow. I want you to go in, and I want you to see if you can hit, you can try to aim at, and I was gonna say hit a target, but it's kind of hard to do that when you're in your house and everything like that. I think one of the best targets to try to hit is, here's our piece of crumpled up paper. Yeah, string, if you're in your basement, you just take some masking tape, tie a string around this, and hang it from the ceiling. And see if you can turn. Whoop. I can't even hang on to it. How could I do it? You can turn and try to kick that thing, you know, with your turn side kick. So not throw it in the air like I just did. You're gonna try to keep it there and pop it through, okay? Now, if you look carefully, I hit it with the top of my foot. I didn't really kick it with the bottom. That would have been too slick. But anyway, the idea is sound though. You got to hang in there. Boom, you just try to turn and get it out there. I think I would have missed it that time. All right, so think about that. You know, crumple a piece of paper, tie some string on it, fishing line, whatever. Tape it to a rafter or tape it to the ceiling or just make sure your mom and dad know about what you're doing. Have a clear area and see if you can punch it. You know, see if you can, what else could you do with it? Well, maybe you can elbow strike it. I guess that'd be pretty easy. You can try to knee tap it. You can get your leg up that high. You can try to kick it straight on or with a front kick. Don't kick it. Sometimes you might catch it though and knock it right off the, with so much power, it'll knock it right off the ceiling or something like that. So make sure you don't hit it too hard. But then if you can, turn, try to kick it with your front side kick. All right, don't lose your balance like I just did. All right, so. Fair enough, all right? Let's call that our combinations that we were practicing for this class. Now I wanna share a few things with you. It's like going to Heian Shodan and stuff. You're going, oh boy, Heian Shodan. I want you to think about it in a different way, all right? I've got my, let me do it this way. I've got my right arm out there, all right? So just to review, where are we? I go down with my left, boom. Right, I step with, my right, and I go down with my right, and I do this wrist, right? And then I come in here and drive. Just kind of loosely, just kind of going through the motions, no impact or anything like that. Let's say somebody grabs my arm. Okay, I want this arm to come up here. Our first move is with our left arm. Let's say we're doing a handshake. Now, we're going to go like this here. So if that's your right arm and this is my right arm, we'll shake hands this way, if that makes sense. So we're going like this, all right? Now, pretend somebody's got a hold of your wrist. Now, this is kind of awkward doing this on camera, but I want you to think about it this way. Somebody's got a hold of our wrist or a hold of our sleeve or some part of us like this, some down lower part of the arm though. Otherwise, this might be this wouldn't be the motion for it. I want to go like this here, all right? And let's just say someone's grabbing here because I want to do the very first movement of Hiyan Shodan. Somebody's got me by this arm here like so. I want to take my hand here, my left arm. I want to come over the top and I want to run it along the front edge, the top of my arm here like this. Knock their hand away. Now that won't always work because I got to have two effects going here. I've got to have my hand going this way that has a certain amount of momentum, and then my hand going this way, which is going to pull my hand free. So I'm going to go like so and knock their hand free. You know where you see this? In any number of different sports. You'll see this, you can see this in wrestling. You can see this in jiu-jitsu, you can see this, well, of course you see it in karate. And you see it in any time I'm trying to dislodge something off my hand here. Boom, I drive, my both hands have to work together. So we could be grappling and use what we call a down block. Even though a down block is not necessarily what it is. That's just how we describe it in Hiyan Shodan. Did you get all that? So what I'm doing here is I'm going to be like, imagine I'm like this. And some guy reaches over and grabs me. We're getting into a tussle here. And I come in and boom, I take my arm and knock it down this way. Right? And this might be just a push. And I continue that motion. Maybe I'm just breaking free and getting him out of there. Who knows? I'm not doing a down block of a front kick, though. That's going to break this arm. If somebody really is trying to blast us and block this with my little skinny arm up top here, that's not going to work. So you understand that now. Karate and our forms are designed to be done really close and for self-defense, not for sparring. That's a different thing. So having said that, I'm going to turn my back to you. And we're going to go through Hiyan Shodan. So, I want you to think about how that hand blocks down. Before I turn, let me just drive that point home. I'm going to be here. And what have I turned? Since the attacker's coming from this side, I'm going to turn toward that attacker. I got my hand. Let's say my hand's out here. I'm going to move my left side forward. And that's what happens. I'm going to go here like so. All right? I'm going to knock that arm off there. Knock that arm off of my wrist, so to speak. All right? So here we go. Ready? And down. And then punch. Boom. I'm doing a mirror image. I'm going to stay with you here for the first half. I come down here to this way. The same kind of thing. Somebody grab my wrist. This time I'm going to do a rotation. A different move. Same result. I step in. Boom. Now I step. Here I go. Just right where we're talking about. Now you got me here. It can be a different way now. You got me this way. I take you here. Here. Whoa, get close. Just like so. All right, that's the first part of what? Hiyan Shodan. So here we go. Let's go through the motions, what you need to do. At gold, at orange, at green, even purple and purple stripe. But let's just talk about what we need to do to get our next belt. And this is what I want you to do as a pattern. Okay? So go like this here. We go here like so. First motion is we say Hiyan Shodan, and we say Yoi. And we turn, and we lock down with our left, and then we're just going to walk through this punch here. Lock down with our right. This comes up, and go through here with our punch. Flat down, and we're going to go three of them now. One, two, and I'm going to turn all the way around. Boy, that's a whole another lesson right there. And I'm going to knock that arm down again and strike through here. I'm going to pull down this way, and I'm going to strike through here. I'm going to pull down this way. I'm going to go back with three strikes. One, two, and Aya. Fold, open my hands up. One, two, one, and two. And come on back and bow. Okay? And learning how to do that, how to use two hands to block, not just one, gives us many variations. I heard this gentleman who is a karate, he's younger than I am, but boy, he spent a lot of training overseas in Japan and Okinawa. And he's from Sweden, and he was saying in English. So a gentleman from Sweden speaking in English, talking about Japanese and Okinawan karate. Truly international. He was saying a blow, which means like a punch or a strike, is like a throw. Okay, so you can either do that. I can do the same motion. I can either hit, okay, or I can knock somebody down. Or I can block, or I can take somebody's arm and lock it out. So a blow is a throw, as a block is a lock, or the other way around. But they all are the same movement, and we all do them the same way for different reasons and for different levels of intensity or different levels of danger. That's how we'll use that. Today we worked on basic combination, nothing basic about it, I should say, just a fundamental combination for Karate USA, the front kick and the round kick and the punch. And then we did a front kick. We did a front kick to start with, a front round. I showed you a variation where we stay in place and kick. So we can do it in our living room if need be, even in our bedroom. Side turn side, and how to use that side turn side to develop focus and accuracy. It's about keeping your body straight up and learning where to put your eyes, all right? And then we went into form a little bit, and I showed you a little bit about how we can use this motion here, which we call a down block, really as a wrist release, all right, or a self-defense move. Just one application, there's a whole bunch more. With that, I'm just gonna cut you loose, and I'm gonna say, hang on to this recording. You know, this will be in YouTube, and I'll put it some other places that you can find throughout time, and you can refer to it when you'd like to. All right, so till we meet again, salute here, Mike Reiser. Aya. Now I make that long walk over here to hit the off button. Okay. Gosh, I spent a half an hour in hair and makeup too for this class. All right, kind of wore right off.